Hello, this is Alachia, and we're on our way to Ikea. We're just gonna go look around and see what some sort of options are for things. Since we're going to probably be moving into a space that is half the size of our previous residence, things are gonna get really interesting because we have a lot of stuff still. Even though we got rid of a lot, we still have tons more to get rid of and a lot of thinking to do in terms of storage and how to utilize spaces. It's not going to be easy at all. Organizing in large spaces is obviously easier because there's always room to put things in different places. So, the more space you have, the easier it is to organize. However, organizing things that end up being sort of archived tends to be a little bit inefficient. Obviously, when you're living in a city, you want to be as efficient as possible, not as inefficient as possible. So a lot of things come down to figuring out a system. Systems are really important when you're organizing for spaces. Systems of how you want to organize your clothes, systems for storing things, systems for basically arranging things so that you can constantly apply these systems over and over again, and then you get kind of used to where things are supposed to be. Everything has a place. So we're going to see, how I've never really, I take that back. When I was in college, I dealt with very, very tiny spaces. Not as tiny as some, probably not even as tiny as like most New Yorkers, but definitely small. Like my dorm room was small and I shared it with a roommate. And then I lived in an efficiency for a while. And then I shared an apartment with three other girls. So I had very little space. And all my stuff had to fit into one room, basically. So organizing was really tough, and especially because I'd had no like organizing devices, like our furniture. So cabinets, storage units, I didn't have access to that. All I had access really to was Walmart and Target. It's the only things I really could afford. So that's kind of what I had to work with. And so now we have access to things like IKEA, and I did see a couple of furniture places around the city, which I'll probably go look at. But I mean, the problem with going inside the city to look for furniture type pieces is you're going to be dealing with, you know, high design, and that means more money, and really can't afford to spend a lot of money right now. So IKEA is probably like our best bet. So that's why we're going there, just to look around. And also IKEA is really good to sort of get ideas for designs for small spaces, how to arrange furniture, different types of options for like storage devices. A lot of that stuff you can actually buy cheaper units or come up with your own system to mimic that and not have to get the whole system. But IKEA is pretty cheap, so I'm not too worried about that. So I'm gonna go look around and we'll see what I think and come up with some ideas. We've basically gone from a 4-bedroom house to a 1-bedroom apartment, which will be very, very interesting. No garage, no closets. There is one room that's kind of like a wardrobe room, which we're gonna have to sort of see about getting a storage unit for to house my clothes, in which I'm gonna have to develop a system because there's no way all my clothes are gonna be accessible to me at any one given time. I will have to figure out a way to store summer clothes and fall clothes and go to winter clothes, etc., and rotate them in and out because they're not gonna fit. Or I'm gonna have to have some sort of way to, like, you know, have access, easy access to the things I wear on a weekly basis versus a monthly, or, you know, every once in a fun while. So, all right, I'll check back in after we get to IKEA. Maybe I'll be able to film some in IKEA. We'll see. So here's a small, I like the benches. I'm gonna try the benches. €69. Tiny little kitchen. I like those light fixtures, but Sad has sort of vetoed no to them. Is that a toaster oven? I wonder if we're gonna have a microwave. I forgot to ask him that.
I doubt it.
I like the idea of the stuff on the rollers. in our spaces so that we can easily move things if we decide to change or rearrange. Really regretting bringing half of our furniture because, I want one with hangers. This is a bathroom. I like this. Oops. Really would love to be able to get this installed. Something like that with two sinks and lots of storage underneath. Be perfect. Yeah, that's great. Would like a wooden seat toilet. See, it's back here. This is for dirty clothes. Whites and darks, maybe? Whites? Darks? I wish our bookshelves looked like that. Yeah, I like that. Mm-hmm. It wouldn't even fit, though. It's too big. That's what she said. Probably could install something like this over the bed. And this would give you tons more space. Yep. So your pants a lot longer than that. You have to fold them like 3 times. Oh, I like that above the bed. It's really smart. What do you think?
What?
For like above the bed and stuff? Extra storage?
It's only 20 bucks.
Well, euro. It's different. Oh, look at that. See, that'd be perfect. And then you have a guest bed and a couch. Living room set, trying to figure out how we're gonna put the TV and all. One of those would be good enough. It would fit on one of those, right? It's only our 50 inch. We sold our 60 something inch.
A whole bunch of pieces with it. You can mix and match.
Customize.
Too bad none of this is in English.
Well,
customize the doors.
If you mark what it is, the names, like Bestavara, Bestatumbo, whatever, you can go look at the English version online. All sorts of TV solutions. I don't like that. Sad loves this. He likes this sort of shiny finish on things, but I think it looks very Miami Vice. I am not a fan. What do you think about that? We're going to have very limited room in the kitchen. So something like this for a dining table would be great because then we could fold both that down, and if we have guests over, maybe we pull it out and then flip that part up and it'd be a bigger table. It's kind of neat. And then I was thinking that, you know, we could use these things for like storage for silverware and napkins. I like that. It's about 185 euro, I think. Not including the chairs. But we have some things we can use for now for chairs. What you doing in the bathroom?
That's pretty cool.
Yeah?
And take a leak. But I don't know if there's any running water.
That actually looks like an American toilet.
This is kind of like what we have, huh?
Yep.
That'll hold a towel.
And it's going to drag on the ground.
It almost worked against the door.
Yep. You mean where the door is, in between them? Does it come with that, or is that separate?
I think it comes with, well, it's a separate piece.
I'm telling you, we're going to have to downgrade on towels. Downsize on towels, I mean. This is kind of cool. I don't think our sink is anything like that, though.
This is only half the size of one of my closet. I guess you could...
Well, you could stack most of your t-shirts in drawers.
Not do this, move this up one.
Yeah. I like this bed headboard a lot, but Sad's pretty skeptical, but I think it's cool, because it's pretty spacious. I mean, we're not going to have room to pull that whole thing out, but we could store stuff back there and then put it back. Yeah. And I like how they're really low profile beds. Most of these don't have box springs and whatnot. Oh, is it? Yeah, see the cord. It's probably not plugged in, is it? I bet there's a system where you pull the door back and the light comes on. That would probably make the most sense. I like these things. But I don't know what you do. Is it on wheels or something? Ah, it is. Huh. That's kind of neat. I wonder if, like, if you made this into sort of your headboard. And it can roll. Can it roll past the headboard? I wonder. Oh, this thing's blocking it. So that'd be kind of neat. Anyways, trying to find bed with storage underneath it. Like that one. But I don't like the color of that one. Or put your shoes.
You get storage up there. Maybe put a shelf there, maybe.
Yep, that could work. I do have a lot of pants.
Not even like a fourth of your clothes. I won't get what all this new take pictures is, so it means.
How's that one?
It's just shelves. Mm.
No, I like that one. Pax Vicadal. Just looking.
I'm just talking about when we do move in and get all this.
This haben wir.
This is the kind of the sink that we have in the bathroom. And what we were thinking is we would buy a unit that goes underneath it, like this,
and it goes around the sink.
It's built around the sink, like that one, quite a bit, and that would give us extra storage and make room underneath the sink. These are all just ideas for now, right? Just left IKEA, and that place is fucking huge. Every time I go in there, I'm always surprised at how large that place is. And it's gigantic, and it's pretty much linear, so you can only go, not linear, but it's basically one way, and it just directs you through the entire store, so you have to go through the entire store. There's a couple of shortcuts, but we looked at a bunch of closet storage systems, which we thought looked really doable. Again, we're going to have to downsize like a motherfucker because there's no way. We don't even have a quarter of the closet size we used to have. So we're going to have to figure out a system that works for us. Looked at some kitchen stuff and dining. Our dining room table is basically going to have to shrink a ton. And what else did we look at? Mostly storage units, I think. We found some under the cabinet, under sink storage that we were kind of hoping we'd be able to get. So, again, all that stuff has to be measured and we have to look at it more closely. But just sort of seeing our options right now. So, and it looks pretty doable. So, we'll see how this all works out. And once we get into the space and once we see what we already have and how much we still have yet to organize, then we'll have a better idea of what we need. Now we're gonna go to Media Mart and go buy some razors, not a razor, clippers to shave Daisy's head. Hair! I'm tired. And also this weekend I'm gonna go over to see Lily in Vegas again, and I cut Vegas's hair last week, kind of like a spur of the moment thing where, you know, they were just sort of talking about how I basically offered it up because I knew how to do it, and they didn't really know how. So I did Vegas's hair, and now they want me to come back and do Lily's, and then they're gonna cook us dinner and all that. So thought we'd bring some clippers over and then go ahead and just shave them as well. And plus, we need it for Daisy. We've been stealing Tivy and Taints for the longest time, and sort of need our own. And plus, we need one with 220 volts. That's the other thing. A lot of our stuff is all this 120 volt stuff, and it's just not even going to be able to work, so I don't even know why we brought it. It's one of those things that you just don't even bother bringing that kind of stuff if you come over to Europe. I mean, there's a couple of converters that you can get for smaller things, like, I don't know, like your phone charger maybe, or something really tiny that doesn't take up a lot of them. What are you smirking about?
It's dual voltage, you can bring it.
Oh. If it's dual voltage, you can bring it. Otherwise, you need a converter. But we don't have that many things that are dual voltage. So.
We have a lot of things that are dual voltage.
Like what?
Televisions, computers.
Oh, phones. Those are big things, though. The, like, lamps and stuff. Stop laughing at me. That's not nice. Stop making fun of me. So we're going to Media Mart for that. And then I'm going to head back home. So I think Daisy's going to go insane because we've left her like 3 times today. Okay. So we got back from Media Mart and this is what we got. Philips 100% turbo power. Cuts all hair types. Extra strong motor, heavy weighted for optimal control, ultra silent, rechargeable cord and cordless in a storage case. And it comes with scissors and a comb or something. So good to go with Daisy, and she can shave her head. And someone else is thinking about shaving his head too. Is that true? Me too. Just kidding. All right, headed back to the hotel. What do I call? It's not home, so it sucks. Be nice when we get to go home and we're actually home and not in the dingy hotel.
Daisy will be glad to see us. So.
Turn
all
right,
I'll be the same.